गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर कॉमर्स क्लास. सो आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर स्टेइंग सेफ एंड हेल्दी एट योर होम्स. सो येस्टरडे यू ऑल नो दैट वी हैव डन द टॉपिक ऑफ सुपरविजन, वन ऑफ द मेन एलिमेंट्स ऑफ डायरेक्टिंग. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू वन एक्सपेंशन और वन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ सुपरविजन, दैट इज स्पैन ऑफ कंट्रोल. It is very important topic from the viewpoint of your board exams also. So today, plus two commerce, your chapter number 11 and topic directing, we will cover the span of control, which is also called span of supervision, span of management, also span of responsibility. So it is known by different names. It was developed by Sir Ian Hamilton. Ian Hamilton gave the concept of span of control. So before doing the topic, let us first do the learning objectives. Why we are doing this topic, what you will be able to learn after the topic is over. First of all, to develop clear goals and policies, to delegate tasks effectively, to select and train employees carefully, to increase responsibility on employees, to boost higher value of morale. So you'll be able to learn all these after the topic is over. Okay, let us first go through the mind map of the chapter. So at the end of the chapter, you will be able to learn about meaning of directing, nature, its importance, principles, techniques, supervision, leadership, then motivation and communication as well. So in this chapter, the key terms under this topic which we are going to cover is, first of all, cross relationships, V.A. Grekuner's theory, span of management, direct single relationships and planogram. Listen to the topic carefully, only then you are able to justify and explain these new terms. Also read page 297 till 300 before listening the video so that you can get more out of the video. Follow the reference link given here for more clarity of the same concept, that is span of management. Okay, you all know about Reliance Group, Reliance Industries Limited, RIL Group. It's a very well-known name, which is India's number one company. So it has one branch that is known as Reliance Market or RMart, dealing with fresh vegetables, fruit, clothing, apparel, footwears, and other than that, grocery items. Its first store was opened in 2011. Now it has about 52 stores, a wholesale and cash carrying store chain. So what is its logo? Yahan sab milega, sab milenge. So it's a store where you can get everything under one roof. Its principle is buy for less, operate for less, and sell for less. Other than these, we also have other reputed companies like Tata, Reheat, Piramal, Goenkas. They are also very reputed companies in the same line of chain stores. Now, the Reliance Market deals in MBO. This term is very important for Commerce Group. MBO, that is multi-brand outlets. Here in Reliance Market, the supervisors are called as category killers. They are not supervisors, they are actually designated as category killers, and they do planogram. Now, what is planogram? Arranging different and a huge variety of products in different sections, in different stores, so that to make their display proper and for the convenience of the customers. So now, what do these category killers, the supervisors of RMart, actually do? First of all, how is their supervisory ability judged? Number of employees over number of managers. So what I am trying to say here, how many number of workers a supervisor can control effectively? Like, I have a class of 40, I can manage it properly. Suppose if class becomes double, it becomes 80, will I be able to manage it? Maybe not. So my span of control is 40. Similarly, how many number of supervisors a manager or a supervisor can control easily and effectively is called span of control, span of management. Similarly, here the number of employees divided by number of managers, that how many employees can a manager tackle properly. Now we have two types of spans, a row span and adjusted span of control. Raw span is also called reporting structure. Now here are managers and employees, number of managers. Now we are discussing employees per manager, right? So when it reduces, it becomes raw span, a rough outlook. Like, I have appointed you as a monitor. Now you have made a group in the class, and that group consists of 10 students. So 10 students is your span of control. Now they have a closeness of contact, my manager. Now how it is judged? Number of employees divided by the time percentage of manager, that how long he can well manage that group. Suddenly a raw span changes into full time equivalent. So when all the requirements are fulfilled, managers are satisfied with the work of supervisors, they are well enough satisfied with the employees working under one group, then it becomes adjusted span of control after all requirements taken and brought inside. Okay, now we have two types of span of control. One is narrow span of control and another is wide span of control. Narrow span of control is also called long span of control, and wide span of control is also called flat span of control. First of all, let us discuss narrow span of control. So look here, a manager is there, three employees are working under him, and one of his employee is tackling two more employees. So here, each employee holding a position of authority is responsible for at least two others. Employee is responsible for two other employees. So span of control is two only. The number of employees he can hold is span of control. So here number of employees is just two. So span of control is two. This is narrow span of control. Least the number of employees you can handle, the term it is narrow span of control. So what is its advantage? First of all, quick and easy communication. He can easily communicate with these employees. Effective feedback. Moreover, these employees can give review easily to their boss. Okay, next comes wide span of control. Wide means where number of employees are more. So here is manager who has about 6 employees working under him. Now second employee holds a position of authority and is responsible for 5 more employees. So here span of control is 5. So each employee holding a position of authority is responsible for at least 5 others. So here span of control is at least 5. So this is called wide span of control. What could be its advantages? First is less layers of management. So there is not very a long hierarchy. It's a flat structure where one employee is tackling 5 employees, other employees is tackling other 5 employees and so on. Cost less money because you need not so many number of supervisors. So that's why it needs less money to give them salary or pay them. Now, what are the various factors that affecting the width of a span of control? That whether it should be a narrow one or a wider one. First of all, the type of product being made. What kind of products are made in the organization? If product line is vast, then it should be narrow span of control so that every product must be managed. Then skill of managers and workers, that how the managers and workers are able to tackle with the workers properly. How many number of subordinates they can control. So span means a distance between the tip of a thumb, hold your thumb, see the tip, and the small finger. So there is a gap between tip of a thumb and a small finger. And see when a palm of hand is fully stretched out, stretch your palm. So what happened in that, you can actually know how many fingers are in between. So how many fingers are there? 3 fingers. So span of control is 3. So now in terms of management, it refers to a power to direct, to order. A specific number of people which can be effectively controlled and supervised. Wider the span of control, more the number of people. Narrow the span of control, less the number of people are working under one manager. But it is all dependent on manager's talent. Okay, now we will discuss about V.A. Greconis theory. He was a manager, and on the basis of his experience, he gave a theory that is an expansion of span of control. An extension of span of control. Now, he has given a formula to calculate R. Now, R is number of relationships. How to calculate N? Within bracket, 2 raised to the power N divided by 2 plus N minus 1 and big bracket closes. So N is here number of subordinates. So by using Greconis formula, we can calculate total number of relationships if the number of subordinates is given. Okay, let us do an example. If a superior has 5 subordinates and N is 5, that is number of subordinates, then the number of relationships R which has to be controlled can be calculated as follows. So here I have alternative used different subordinates. If number of subordinates is 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5 and 6 also. So number of relationships also increased, that the value of R also increases. So R would be 1. In case of 2 subordinates, it is 6. In case of 3, it is 18. In case of 4 subordinates, relationships are 44. In case of 5 subordinates, relationships are 100. And in case of 6 subordinates, relationship goes to 122. Okay, let us solve. If suppose number of subordinates is 5 and we have to find R. So here I have put the value of N is equals to 5. 2 raised to the power N means 2 raised to the power 5 divided by 2 plus N minus 1 which is equals to 5 minus 1. So here multiply 2 5 times. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 2's are 16 and 16 2's are 32. So 32 comes here divided by 2. 32 when divided by 2 we will get 16. And 4 from this, 5 minus 1, Now 16 plus 4 is equals to 20. Multiply it by n. So 5 into 20 is equals to 100. So in this way, the relationships, when number of subordinates is 5, it comes out 100. So same way, we can also calculate for the given table as I have shown you earlier. Now, according to V.A. Gregunas, there are three types of superior subordinate relationship. First is direct single relation. Here, suppose n is 1, so there is nothing to find. Direct group relation, and in that our formula becomes n 2 raised to the power n over 2 minus 1. And when there are cross relationships, our formula becomes n within bracket n minus 1. So if the number of relationships increases, so then our formula also diversifies. So what are cross relationships here? That is, the mutual relationships among subordinates working under a common superior. So now you have done about V.A. Gregunas' theory, what we can judge out of it. So first of all, in V.A. Gregunas' theory, some of the results of the different relationships will give up number of relationships which can be used and directly calculated by using the formula. So according to V.A. Gregunas, the number of subordinates increases, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on. Similarly, the number of relationships which the superior has to control also increases almost geometrically, like 1, 6, 18, 44, 100, 222, etc. Therefore, a superior can only control a limited number of subordinates, and anything beyond this limit is very hard to control. So he defines a fixed limit of number of subordinates. Moreover, V.A. Gregunas added that a top level manager can effectively manage only 222 relationships. Therefore, a top level manager should not have more than 6 subordinates. So this was all about V.A. Gregunas' theory. Now we will do factors affecting span of control. So what thing one should keep in mind to decide how many number of employees can a manager handle? First of all, capability of the superior. When the superior is experienced, he has adequate knowledge about workers and maintains good relation with workers, he will be able to supervise more workers. Next is capability of subordinates. When subordinates are competent, qualified, they can have self-control, so they require less supervision and it will increase wider span of control. Next, it depends on nature of work. When the work is of routine, repetitive nature, it requires less supervision, leading to wide span of control. Again, if the work is of specialized nature, varying nature, that it daily it changes, then narrow span of control should be there. Next is clarity of plans. When plans are clear and role of subordinates are well defined, then frequent supervision will not be required. Next is degree of decentralization. With a high degree of centralization, span of control will be narrow. When degree of decentralization is high, a manager can supervise large number of workers, resulting in a wider span of control. Next we have staff assistance. With the availability of advice from assistants, advisors, the workload of managers reduce and it allow managers to supervise large number of workers. Next is location of operations. When the branches of business are dispersed, they are widely dispersed, so it will be difficult for managers to supervise every branch. So in such a situation, span of control will be wider. Next is techniques of communication and control. So, effective system of communication and control will lead to a big span of control. Levels of management. Span of control is required at low level as well as high level. So, at low level, it will be wider and at high level, it will be narrow. Last is value addition. A manager who adds value by giving them training, by developing their skills, will need a narrow span of control because he will not be able to teach a large group at one time. So, to find out how many superiors are needed, considering the number of employees to be supervised in the organization is known as span of control. So, I hope topic is now clear to all of you. So, span of control means how many number of workers a supervisor can control effectively. So, a span of control is number of people who report to one manager in a hierarchy. It is also called span of supervision, span of management, span of responsibility. It is made up of two words, span and control. So, span means stretching out and controlling means instructions. So, span of control means extending your instruction area. So, now you will all be able to answer the following questions. First of all, what is span of control? What are the various factors affecting it? Explain V.A. Gregoire's theory. Differentiate between narrow and wider span of control. So, the topic is almost over. Now, tomorrow we will start with another element of directing, that is motivation. Thank you.